Welcome to Getting Started with Caché Tools. In this video, we will show some of the tools used in Caché to develop applications and manage the system. The first is Studio. As we learned earlier, Studio is an IDE for writing application code. This includes server-side business logic as well as Caché server pages, Xen or Xen Mojo for the front end. The next is Terminal, which is the command line interface for Caché. The terminal is one way you can manage and configure the system, and it can also be used to test code written in Studio. Another way to manage the system is through the management portal. This is a browser-based tool for managing and configuring the system, and since it runs in a browser, it is OS independent. You can perform many of the same activities from either the terminal or the management portal. Finally, there is the documentation, which is an expansive reference guide for Caché. It includes manuals for development and system management and contains the class reference guide for viewing APIs. You can run any of these tools locally or remotely. Typically, you will connect your machine to the server where Caché has been installed. Let's take a look at each of these tools. Let's first open Studio from the Inner Systems Launcher. Studio is used for creating classes and writing code within Caché. When you open Studio, you must choose which namespace to connect to. Your code will then be saved and compiled within that namespace. Let's open the sample.person class. Here is a sample class definition that defines how information about people will be stored in the database. Properties are the data elements to be stored, and the methods are actions that you can perform on the sample.person objects. We can also create new classes. As an example, let's create a simple new class that contains a method. We can type code for a simple method that writes "Hello World" out to the screen. We can then test this method in terminal shortly. Terminal is the command line interface for Caché. It is useful for testing out code that you've written. It is also used to manage the system through various system routines. The system can also be managed with the management portal. When we open it from the launcher, it loads in the default browser. The management portal is divided into three main sections: System Operation, System Explorer, and System Administration. System Operation is where you can perform activities on the system such as reading logs, managing processes, and running backups. This page shows all of the Caché processes currently running on the system. System Explorer is where you can view data and query the system with SQL. Finally, System Administration is where you can configure the system. This includes creating namespaces and databases and configuring memory settings. Documentation for Caché is stored locally and can be accessed through the launcher. The front page of the documentation lists a variety of Caché manuals. For example, the Caché installation guide describes how to install Caché and configure its memory settings for each OS. There are also guides on development, bindings with other languages, and management of the system. The class reference guide details all of the class definitions and the methods available in Caché. Most methods will also have an explanation of use. For example, let's look at the backup.general class. Methods of this class can be used to call into Caché externally for purposes of running backups. Tools can all be run locally, but typically a user will run them while connecting to another server with remote system access. We do this by defining in the launcher the location of the other server and then choosing which of the tools we want to run on that server. In this video, we discuss the tools available to get started using Caché to develop applications and to keep Caché operating efficiently.